Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to discuss an important topic which can very well be asked in the examination which is coming up in the English section. So this video is for English and it talks about the essay topics which are important for the upcoming examination and which can be asked. So all those viewers who are preparing for NABARD mains, who are expecting to get through prelims and be giving mains, and also students who are preparing for RBI and SEBI. All these pointers are also going to be important for you. So don't you think that we are not writing NABARD mains. So this is not important for us. The topic that I have for discussion today is very important. It says, is MSP still relevant in ensuring farmers' welfare in India? Now it says, is MSP still relevant? Therefore, it's asking you a question. So you have to show both sides. Okay, yes, MSP is still relevant for farmers' welfare, and no, it is not relevant anymore for farmers' welfare, for FW farmers' welfare. So you show both the sides and then you come to a conclusion as to what should be done in the future in order to ensure the central objective of farmers' welfare. So let's talk about this. As I have always been telling you in the introduction, we are going to talk about the definition, or we are going to define one of the keywords, and then we'll talk about also the importance. So we talk about both these. Okay, so how do you define? First of all, you identify the keywords. Number one, MSP, that's the most important keyword and that's the central theme of the essay. And then the second one is farmers' welfare, that's the second keyword. So whatever you're going to write in the essay is going to revolve around MSP and its linkages with farmer welfare. Okay, so that is your focus area. Whatever MSP does for anything other than farmers' welfare is not important for us. Whatever we are going to discuss should be focused on impact of MSP on farmers' welfare. Keep that in mind. Okay, so define MSP. What is MSP? Price of an agricultural produce determined by Government of India. The price at which government directly purchases from the farmers. Not difficult to write, very layman, very normal kind of a definition that I've given. Number two, importance of MSP. It fulfills multiple objectives, provides a fair price to farmer in case of sharp fall, using MSP procured grains for PDS distribution. The central objective of MSP for anything. What is the central objective? Fair price to farmer and using the same for PDS distribution. Therefore, ensuring that everyone has food on his or her plate at the end of the day. Okay, so these are the major objectives of MSP. Now, does it actually fulfill these objectives? We have to figure that out by telling how is it still relevant for farmers' welfare and how is it not relevant anymore for farmers' welfare. Okay, so let's talk about the relevance first. How is it relevant? Number one, it provides minimum guaranteed price to the farmers. I hope you understand what is MSP minimum support price and how does it work. I'm not going to discuss that because I'm assuming that you have already read all those things. It's very simple, no rocket science involved here. What is minimum support price? How does it work? Not to be discussed. You directly jump to how exactly is it relevant for farmers' welfare. It provides a minimum guaranteed price to the farmer, therefore reducing the vulnerability of farmer in agriculture or reducing the unpredictability and thus working towards farmers' welfare. It incentivizes farmers to produce more as they are guaranteed an assured market for their produce. So let's say you start producing, let's say mobile phones tomorrow, and the government comes and says, okay, we are going to buy, you know, 1 lakh of mobile phones. Or let's say Mahindra starts producing more of electric vehicles and the government says, let us buy 1 lakh vehicles from you, which we are going to provide to all the taxi wallahs. Mahindra is very happy because now they have a guaranteed buyer and therefore they will be incentivized to produce more and more electric vehicles, and it's going to, you know, turn into a positive cycle wherein more electric vehicles on the road will incentivize more people to come and buy more electric vehicles from Mahindra directly. So it does incentivize the farmer to produce more because now they're guaranteed. It provides a psychological support to farmers, which is very important because this has been mentioned because of high suicide rates. So you can also connect it with the, you know, number or the intensity of suicide in farming or in agriculture in India. So it does provide a psychological support, and also it works as an options contract. If you're writing RBI exam, then this can be your first point also because it's a little more technical. Why or how does it work as an options contract? It does work as an option contract in the way that if the price falls below the MSP, this is the MSP, let's say 100 rupees, rupees 100 per kg. If the price in the market goes below MSP, the government has the obligation to buy at the MSP. Let's say the market price is, let's say 60 rupees per kg. So the farmer, this is the farmer goes to the government and says, okay, the market price is only 60. My cost price is more, but because of bumper crop, I'm not being able to sell it at a high price. I want to at least cover my costs. My cost is, let's say, 95 rupees. The government says, okay, we have declared a price of MSP of 100 rupees. We are willing to buy it at rupees 100. We have to buy it at rupees 100 from you. Sell it to us. So the government has an obligation to purchase from farmers at the MSP. At the same time, the farmer is under no obligation to sell the government if the price stays above MSP. Let's say the market price is, 120 per kg. Why will the farmer go to the government and sell it at rupees 100 when he can already sell it at a higher price of rupees 120 per kg? So the farmer has advantage on both the sides. The price goes down, he can sell it at MSP. The price is up, he can sell it in the market at the market price itself. So those are the advantages, and therefore that's how it works as an options contract. How is it not relevant anymore? This forms a major part of our discussion. The reason being that there is a heavy debate which has been going on the future of MSP in India, because a lot of economists and a lot of bureaucrats, a lot of specialists have been talking about rationalizing subsidies and replacing these kind of subsidies with more efficient, more futuristic subsidies which can actually change the fate of farmers for the long term, change the fate of farmers in the long term. For example, providing him with a tractor, providing him with free electricity, providing him with free and round the clock water, providing him with the good seeds, with a good market so that he can sell directly to the consumer and is not exploited. All those are structural reforms. All those are technically structural reforms that are required from the government. And these economists say that spend that money on those structural reforms so that the farmer is self-sufficient. He does not need your help. He does not need to come to you to sell his produce. He can go to the market and sell it himself at a good price. Okay. So that is one important reason that there is a debate ongoing about the relevance or non-relevance of MSP in Indian market. So the first point is the country no longer faces food shortage and does not need food security because of bumper crops. And therefore, the primary purpose that I talked about in the introduction, wherein everybody's plate was supposed to be full at the end of the day, that is not important anymore, or that has already been done by the government since 1960s. So we don't need that anymore. What we need is to rationalize these subsidies, change these subsidies, and increase farmers' income in the long run so that he's self-sufficient in the future. Okay, so that is basically called as looping, wherein, let's say, this is the point that you started from, number one, and this is the second point, number two, and it closes the loop. One and two bring each other together. So that's called looping, and it's very important for essays. It helps the reader create a strong linkage in his mind. Government should spend more on infrastructure, irrigation, farmer education, etc., etc. MSP increases the fiscal burden of the government but does not provide any benefit to the future generation of agriculture. So that's the major point. MSP is a short-run measure and is not sustainable. It does not provide long-term benefits to farmers. Also, it does not address the structural problems of Indian agriculture. MSP does not reach all the farmers and to all crops. So it has in the past, although this has now been changed since the past 2 to 3 years, it has resulted heavily in monoculture in India, wherein only rice and wheat have been given importance by farmers, just for the simple reason that they could go and sell it to the government directly. So they were not dependent on the market fluctuations anymore. So therefore, it did not reach all crops and therefore resulted in very strong yet very dangerous monoculture, tradition of monoculture. Secondly, it does not reach all the farmers. It has been proved that majority of the farmers, majority of small and marginal farmers are actually not aware about MSP or are not able to take advantage of MSP. it is the rich ones who are actually taking advantage of MSP. Another major structural problem with MSP, and this is very important, that MSP before some time used to be lower than the market prices. That is why it used to be called as minimum support price, wherein let's say the cost of farmer is 95, the MSP is let's say 100, the market price is let's say 120, but the farmer does not have the means to sell it in the market because he's very small or he's weak and he cannot go and sell it, or he's unable to get this kind of price without being exploited, or majority of his produce can be wasted if he waits long enough for the market price. So he wants a guaranteed income, he's happy with this margin of 5 rupees only, he uses that. Now what has happened is the market price is 120, but the MSP on the other hand is let's say 150. So instead of acting as a support price, it is actually defeating the market price and therefore changing the economic structure of the market, wherein the market price, which has been determined by demand and supply, should be ruling, but that does not happen. And therefore, it defeats the entire purpose of minimum support price. It is not minimum anymore, it is above the market. It is not supportive anymore, it is changing the entire market structure. It is actually defeating changing the structure in such a way that the market price being determined by the demand and supply is not being done anymore. The next one is system creates glut of certain crops. There is intensive cultivation of a single crop that I've already explained before. It discourages private investment in the sector. The reason, the primary reason, is that the government intervention is so high that private sector does not want to be a part of agriculture. Why? Let's say you are a farmer and you grow certain crops, and let's say a company says that, okay, let us try and do the same thing that the farmer is doing, but the company has to go and sell it in APMC mandis only. So these are the APMC mandis that are there. So instead of, you know, selling directly to the consumer who is standing here, they have to go through these middlemen called as APMCs. The margins are certainly low. The investments of these investors who are private investors reduces because they have to go through these mandis, go through these middlemen who are very exploitative in nature. So the private investor says, let's not get into this, it's not very beneficial, because in any case we have to be dependent on these middlemen in order to sell to the consumer. The laws are such, or the government intervention is such, that we cannot sell it directly to the consumer. Our margins and our investment is not going to be for our advantage in the long run. We want to put a crore, or let's say 10 crores, in finding out and installing the right machinery, but it's not beneficial anymore. Farmers should be provided with income support rather than MSP. This has become, income support is crop neutral, which will allow farmers to better diversify. Let's say you are a farmer living in Bundelkhand region, wherein pulses and dry crops like pulses, or let's say maize, those are natural to those areas, and therefore it's more beneficial if you produce those. The chances of crop failure are less. But MSP does not allow you to do it, because you want to sell to the government directly. You don't want to be reliant on the market forces, and therefore it does not allow the farmer to produce crops which are local to that area and which should be produced. Therefore, it's not crop neutral. Income support, on the other hand, is crop neutral. Actual cost of production differs from place to place due to difference in irrigation infrastructure, etc., but MSP is the same. Therefore, it is not the right attitude and not the right policy, because it does not differentiate between farmers based upon their local conditions. It considers all the farmers as the same, which is not a reality. So it does not inculcate empathy towards farmers' specific local needs. Water might be free in UP, water might not be available at all in Maharashtra. So rather than providing him with enough water, you're assuming that he will be able to produce that without any water, or he can do it on his own, and we are going to provide him with a regular or with one single MSP which has been determined at the central level, which is not a good policy. So these are all the points which prove that MSP is relevant in some formats, but at the same time it's losing its relevance. So the conclusion can be that although MSP still provides a lot of support to farmers, considering that our farmer is still not very progressive and not very highly dependent on machinery and futuristic tools and technical details, but at the same time it provides a lot of support to the farmers. Therefore, along with MSP, we have to provide other facilities to the farmers so that we can in phases rule out or totally discard the policy of providing MSP to the farmers and bring structural changes in our agricultural system, which can develop farming as a self-sufficient, as a profitable business for the small and marginal farmers also. Okay, I hope you liked the session. It was a very short session but very informative at the same time. Keep this point in mind, keep this essay topic in mind. Can be asked in the examination. If not in the same way, then it can be asked in some other way as well. Okay, so keep it in mind, keep preparing hard. If you like this lesson, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. By the way, the PDF is available in the description section below, so you can download that, you can keep it with you, you can print it. And if you liked it a lot and if you want to stick to whatever I'm teaching on a regular basis, do not forget to press the bell icon. That will help you to get regular notifications about these videos in the future. Okay, all the very best, take care, have a nice day.